This short video lecture introduces Buys-Ballot's law and the circular movement of the air around low and high pressure areas. At an altitude of around 8 to 15 kilometers above the Earth's surface, the air movement experiences little to no friction. As shown in the short video lecture on the Earth's atmospheric circulation, this results in an equilibrium where the pressure gradient force and Coriolis effect balance each other out, leading to a geostrophic wind parallel to the isobars. But when you are at the Earth's surface, the wind experiences friction by the Earth's surface and any obstacles on it. What then does the equilibrium situation look like? The same mechanism applies. Air moves in the direction of a location with lower energy. Let's take the Earth's surface as a flat level. This then means that air moves to a location with lower pressure, thus by a pressure gradient force. As soon as the air starts to move, the Coriolis effect comes into action, which on the northern hemisphere causes a deflection of the air movement to the right. Equilibrium of the forces involved at the Earth's surface means that the pressure gradient force needs not only to be balanced by the Coriolis effect, that is the equilibrium situation as shown here in the upper part of the troposphere, but now also by the friction force, or in other words, the pressure gradient force needs to be balanced by the resultant of the Coriolis effect, think of it as a force, and friction force, as shown in the following picture. We have high pressure here and a lower pressure here. So this is the pressure gradient force. The air moves, the wind blows. Due to this, not only the Coriolis effect comes into action, but also resistance to the air movement, the friction force. Friction opposes the air movement, so the friction force is in an opposite direction to the air movement. The resultant of the Coriolis force, Cf, and the friction force, Ff, is R, as shown here. R is in equilibrium with the pressure gradient force, Pgf. As the figure shows, for this equilibrium situation to exist, the air movement, the wind, needs to be at an angle with the isobars. And this is stated in Buys-Ballot's law for the northern hemisphere. When you stand with your back to the wind, so your back is in that direction, you're facing that direction, low air pressure is in front of you on your left, and high pressure is behind you on your right. Of course, when you're in the southern hemisphere, the Coriolis effect causes a deflection of the air movement to the left, and then, when you stand with your back to the wind, low air pressure is in front of you on your right, and high pressure is behind you on your left. Christophorus Buys Ballot was professor of physics at Utrecht University and the founder of the Royal Dutch Meteorological Institute. Shortly after formulating his law in 1857, Buys-Ballot discovered that he had empirically verified a theoretical relation deduced 1 year earlier by the American meteorologists James Henry Coffin and William Ferrel. Ferrel gracefully declined Buys-Ballot's later offer to have the law renamed. So, air movement at the Earth's surface is at an angle to the isobars. On the northern hemisphere, this causes the flow of air around a low pressure area to be spiraling inwards as shown in this picture. The air does so in an attempt to counteract the low pressure at the center of this low pressure area or cyclone. Importantly, this converging air movement near the Earth's surface can only take place when there is the possibility for the air to escape upwards from the center of this low pressure area. In the center of a low pressure area, the air rises, expands, and cools, causing the formation of clouds by condensation at a higher level. Precipitation associated with this convergence and uplift of the air is called cyclonic precipitation. The movement around and in high pressure areas shown here is the opposite of what happens around and in low pressure areas. The air movement in the center of a high pressure area is downward, and then the air movement spirals out of the high pressure area as indicated here. So, on the northern hemisphere, we have an anti-clockwise movement around low pressure areas and a clockwise movement around high pressure areas. And of course, in the southern hemisphere, this is the other way around. Clockwise around low pressure areas and anti-clockwise around high pressure areas.